Good morning, my friends. I'm going to repair the crank of my Lister. So you can see what happened. I think the material is very soft. It round itself off here. It is supposed to make an angle like that. And the other side as well to catch the engine, but over time or quickly it rounded itself off so that it don't turn the engine. It tend to push it out. So I'm going to file it now correctly, and then I'm going to do a quenching on this to see if I can make it a little bit harder. And I'm going to use my Primus 632 to hot it up, and I'm going to do a water quenching because all materials is not suitable for oil quenching. That's a long story, but that's my guess. So the chance that I will get it a little bit harder with water, I think it's the best is to do it with water. So let's repair it first. Okay guys, I think that is exactly what I need. You can see the difference, and I test it now on the machine and it grabs it very good. So this is exactly what I want. So let's fire up my Primus. Okay guys, let's fire it up, and I've got the breather out open. So let's light it up and give it time to warm the pipework. Okay, I'll bring you back. Okay, you can see in the center of the screen is the nozzle. There it light automatically, that you see. It is because of the pipework that get heat. So I will give it a little more burn time before I put pressure on. Okay, let's close the vent so that it can build some pressure in the tank. We can pump it a little bit. You can see the smoke from that snail pressure in the tank. There it takes flame. I'll let it heat up more and then give more pressure. Let's pump it a little bit. Okay guys, I'm heating it up. It will not make it red white. The flame is not hot enough, but it will be hot. It's really hot. You can see the bubbles in the paint. Guys, let's quench. Okay, we will test it now. I enjoy this old technology, guys. It's so awesome to use it. Okay, let's take the pressure off. Okay. Right, guys. The quenching is done. Let's start the Lister up. You see, the problem was, guys, every now and then I had to repair it. It seems if this metal is very soft. So hopefully it will last longer now. Okay, guys, I'm going to sit and try and start it. Interesting story to tell you about the Lister now. I just held it a little bit on idle. Listen to how nice it idle. This is beautiful. That's now idling amps and volts. The motor doesn't spin that much, so it doesn't pull a lot. Okay, let's shut it off. I want to explain to you something. Okay, guys, the story is, you've seen it when I started it up, it fires immediately, and then 30 seconds or whatever, it just die, and I paused you, or edit that part out where it die, and I tried to start it and it won't start, and I cleaned the plug, I checked the fuel and do a lot of checkings, but it refused to start, and I've decided, and you remember, this is the brand new plug that virtually doesn't do any work. I wonder if it run 15 minutes or 20 minutes with this plug, maybe more because of that one test, say half an hour. So this is the third new plug fail, guys, just failed. And I didn't know it at the point, but I take the farm wall plug and I put it back and it fired up, and that's what you hear now with the run. You can see there's the farm wall plug. I put that back and it fired right up. So for some reason, today's plugs that fit on cars just pack up very quickly on this Lister, and I don't know why. I can't explain that. So it seems if I need to order a specific Lister plug for it, because otherwise I have a ton of plugs here ready to use the machine, and the formal plugs is already old. So just for interesting sake, this new plug failed. I've got now a handful of already. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed the video of the quenching and it works very nice. And we will see how long it lasts. But the Lister runs very good. Okay guys, see you on the next one. Bye bye.